One thing before we begin, guys, make sure when you're creating your UV maps on your cloth that you do it to the input mesh, okay? So you don't want to do it on the cloth, you want to do it on the original mesh. I've actually made a mistake. I've done all those UV mapping after I've created the cloth, so this is actually a mistake on my part. So the easiest and best solution is just to delete the cloth and reapply those cloth weights once again. It's really fast. It's okay if you've made that mistake. I've actually made this mistake myself, so I've got to watch for this in the near future. So go ahead, make sure you watch out for that problem. That's one of the main problems that you don't want to get whenever creating your UV maps. Now we're going to do some texturing, and before we do texturing, we have to set up our UV maps, okay? Because after we've done all this, you know, modeling, all this messing around with the vertices, our UV texture is going to, well, the UV map itself is going to be absolutely horrible. So if you imagine this square here as a flat image for a Photoshop painter to paint on, there is no way he's going to be able to paint on that, okay? Much less on the 3D model itself. So we need to create our own UVs for all of these objects. Some of these UVs we've got, you know, some pretty simple objects that have okay UV mapping, but again, we're going to have to redo this. So one thing you need is something called a UV map image, and it kind of looks a little bit like this, okay? It's just a quick checkerboard with a bunch of numbers and pretty colors. The only reason why you need this is just so that you can see on your mesh itself how the UV map is deforming, okay? Because this is such a relative, well, quite a complex character, we have to be very careful how it actually looks like. And you can see we've some really, really bad mapping down here. Everything's just horrible, so we'll have to redo this. Now, for complex character mapping, the idea here is to create pieces of your UV map. Now, if you can visualize a t-shirt, for example, the t-shirt that you're wearing, that is in 3D space, kind of a bunch of flat cloth pieces kind of sewn together. In 3D, when we're UV mapping, we're doing the opposite, okay? We're dismantling each piece and laying it out on our UV texture editor right here. It's a time-consuming process, it's pretty boring, I do have to admit, but it doesn't take as long as many people think. So if you know how to do this, you'll find that this is a relatively quick and simple process. So what we're going to do is start with the major components. So all these big, the torso, the head. I'll start with the torso and then we'll move on from there. So first you want to isolate the mesh here, and I'm going to show you the principles just very quickly. Simplest way of doing this is just take a look at your body and then we can make some logical slices. First thing we're going to do is go to create UVs and plan a map, because we've got our UVs everywhere, and I'm just going to project from Z axes and apply, just so that I've got something to start with. Okay. Don't worry about the skewing, that's just the computer being naughty. I'm just gonna do something like this. Okay, and it's a simple process of just going to your edge tool, and I'm going to cut these arms out. And just follow a logical area. I'm just looking at this and I'm thinking, yeah, it looks okay. I may actually want the curve to start from there. Okay, so that kind of makes more sense. And I'm going to do the same for this side as well. And then in my UV texture editor, just cut it using this tool. And once that's cut, nothing really moves. Once it's cut, you can select those UV pieces and then move it up. Now let me just show you quickly how it looks like with the texture map on. So I apologize if you guys struggle to go through this. Like I said, the second series I'm going to go relatively quickly. So we've got much better mapping on our UV here, okay? And you can see the checkerboard, we can see that it's a little bit skewed. That's okay. Next thing we're going to do is the idea, what we're trying to do is get the best amount of deformations, sorry, the least amount of skewing with the least amount of pieces as possible, okay? So I'm going to cut it from the back, and the unfold tool is your best friend in Maya, and that's this unfold tool right here. Unfold selected UVs. Actually, if you go to unfold, make sure you have the option box Just do whatever you need to do. In my case, I'm going to pin the selected UVs. Just click that, and then the computer will try and figure that out. So you've got some great, nice deformations. Now, what justifies you cutting in certain areas? Okay, these are called seams. Where you want these seams is usually in places where people can't really see. Okay, so since my character is mostly going to be visible from the front, I'm going to hide the seam in the back. Okay. And the painters are just going to do their best to try and cover that seam up. So, like what I'm doing, I'm cutting these pieces off. That one's done. I can move it to the side and come back to it later. Now I'm going to move on to the arms. Again, I'm going to grab the edge down here. Same on this side. Make that cut so that we've got these pieces of the arms ready to go. And yes, you know it, it's the seam we're going to hide is probably not under his arm. I may actually put it on, around the back of his arm. It is a bit tricky to make these decisions, guys, so don't fret too much if you don't get it right. It's mainly just comes with experience. Okay, I'm going to make that cut. I'm going to make sure I do the same for this side as well, just so that we're consistent. And then cut that out, and again selecting, just finding a UV point, and then I'm going to unfold, and there we go, those are our arms. Aside from the fact that they are different sizes, that's okay, we've got good some good readings on our arms right there. Right, so that's the simple principles of UV texture mapping. You're taking all those pieces and then you're setting it aside for use later, and then you can tweak it a little bit later as well. So I'm going to keep going and do this, just roughly throw out all these pieces somewhere and on the floor, so to speak, and then we'll tidy it up as we go. All right, guys, time lapse time, let's do this. So guys, as this is going, I do need to describe a couple of things. Firstly, everything you're about to see is utilizing all the basic principles I've shown you. It's the same deal as what you do with the torso or the legs or the head. You're trying to create seams. You're trying to split some areas apart so that you can unfold it and put it down on the floor. Okay. Again, if you can visualize trying to create a t-shirt but doing it backwards, that's what you're trying to do. You're making a selection and then deciding where to make those seams. So essentially, when you get enough experience doing this, you'll find that it's quite automatic. The principles are actually not that difficult to get your head around. People may be very intimidated when it comes to creating all these texture maps and everything, but what you're really doing is just organizing things so that it's easy for you to paint. If you can keep in mind of the painter or the texture artist, you should be fine. And always make sure you put them in areas that kind of make sense. Again, if you're going to be painting your texture, it probably won't matter as much, but chances are you're not going to be doing this all the time. You might want another texture artist to work on this for you. So make sure everything you do is kind of makes sense. For example, what I've done there on the side, you've seen just previously the fingers, I've been just organizing them in order. So you've got the thumb, the index, the middle, etc. And just trying to make it so it looks easy for whoever wants to paint it to actually paint it. Okay, so what I'm doing here now is just changing a few things, just making sure I don't mess things up and make things too messy. Again, you can see the layouts of all those little tiny pieces. Again, I'm just trying to make it work, move them in certain areas and scale them up. Now, in terms of scale of how big the sizes are, normally I would have a little bit more resolution on the face. The reason being is because I want the face to have quite a strong emotive value. And you may need to bring out a lot more textures on the face area. If you're using high resolution textures, it probably won't matter. So always keep in mind what you want to do. What I'm working on there now is the gums, and then just making certain cuts so that I can unfold it and then rearrange them in a way that kind of works. You can see I'm not being totally perfect. I'm not trying to get every single vertice to be absolutely horizontal. All I'm trying to do is just unwrap it so that it works for the texture artist. Now what I'm doing here is deleting a few faces that we don't need. I probably forgot to do that during the modeling stage, so try to be careful whenever you're creating a mesh. Like I said before, it's been I've done this a little bit quicker. So for these segments, these are all the hair segments, and this is actually quite complex, which is the reason one reason why I left it to last. And where it says it's red, it's basically meaning you're seeing the face, the back of its face. And a lot of times you'll find that the unfold tool is very useful for fixing up very complex shapes like this. Again, we're not trying to be super accurate, we just want to get something that works for our texture artist. So I'm just grabbing certain vertices, expanding them, and then unfolding it, basically allowing the computer to do most of the work for me. And that's kind of what you want to do. You want to get to a point where the computer can try and figure a few things out. So the unfold tool is your best friend here. You can see we can quickly expand even extremely complex areas, shapes like that. And you may be worried that when it comes to texturing the hair, it's going to be a huge mess. The reality is you can't avoid distortions on complex meshes like this. You can only minimize them. Distortions are just a fact of, you know, texturing and part of modeling, so you're going to have to paint over that. But with objects like the hair follicles, they don't tend to be very visible. So you may be wondering, okay, well, if they're not visible, then we can be really messy. Well, you can. You actually have more leeway, but you shouldn't try to be too messy. You should just make it in such a way that it still works for the texture artist. Remember, it's what the audience that sees that's very important. So if you can, even if the UV mapping is horrible, it can be actually hidden behind certain objects and it would still work for the audience. So that's the end result of what we're trying to get. Now that segment is probably one exception that I'm not going to try and do because it's too difficult to unfold. So as a result, I'm just going to leave it as it is. The only reason why I'm justifying leaving it is because it's very, very tricky to see and I don't need to put a lot of detail on that anyway. Okay, and once I have all those pieces down, I'm just going to try and organize them in such a way that, again, it makes sense for the texture artist. So just moving them around and tidying them up. I don't recommend using Maya's automatic layout because, again, you need to be able to see where the texture is coming from and what it is. If you're using the automatic layout, it makes it a little bit difficult for you to discern what piece or what UV shell is related to what part of the model. So laying it out by yourself, it will really help you keep in mind where those pieces are and what it relates to. So what I'm doing here is just trying to lay the feet out properly. Some areas can be a little bit tricky to work with, so what I'm trying to do is fudge a lot of the places where I can get the best result. So the teeth and gums, I'm organizing it to be under the head, just so that it makes a little bit more sense. They can be quite small because they don't have a lot of detail. And from here, it's all about just sizing up some of your shells and making sure they make sense in the UV texture editor. Just remember to keep it in the top right hand corner, the top right square there, because mostly that's where we can print out or take a snapshot of those lines, and then we'll bring it into Photoshop and start painting. If you're worried about the scale of all of those shells, just use your intuition. I personally don't mind those little errors. It's probably a lot of it is actually not to scale, and I'm not too worried about that. Again, this is just a tutorial, and I'm just quickly trying to get the point across. Normally, in a full-blown production facility, they would probably try and get everything as accurately as possible. Okay, again, it will depend completely on the style, the quality, or the project. In my case, this is a very simple project. It's not supposed to be highly complicated, and I'm trying to keep things as simple as I can. And once more, just resizing, using my intuition which piece is what and how large or how much texture space I need. And just keep in mind that I'm going to actually be using a fairly high resolution texture, so it'll be about 4K. Just again, just constantly rearranging and tweaking them as I go. Okay, there we go. This is our UV map and it's pretty much ready to go. We're going to bring this into Photoshop and then start painting our character. Okay, so there you have it, guys. I'll see you in the next video.